I've got just some of the best, most silliest questions ever asked in the history of the universe and beyond, and we're going to enjoy them after the news. Half hour to the half hour, exciting times. Let's get an update now on Radio 2, on your Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
We're the BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Jason Kay. A report has found that a woman who murdered the baby she was trying to adopt lied to professionals about how much she drank and about her mental health problems. Laura Castle shook 13-month-old Leyland James Corkhill in January last year. A safeguarding review found there were systemic failings with the adoption process. Cumbria County Council said it had already made changes. Leyland James was taken from his birth mother, Laura Corkhill, shortly after he was born. In an interview with the BBC, she shared the words she read out at her son's funeral.
Mummy, please don't be sad. I miss you so much too. I'm safe. It's so beautiful up here. But I do worry when I see you cry. Sorry.
The final touches are being made for tonight's opening ceremony at the Commonwealth Games in Birmingham. For the first time, para events for disabled athletes will be part of the main competition. The event will be the most expensive of its kind since the London Olympics in 2012. The two Conservative leadership candidates, Rishi Sunak and Liz Truss, are facing calls to meet the Prime Minister to agree more support to help people with soaring energy bills. Boris Johnson said it was inevitable that people sometimes faced periods of difficulty. The government has pointed to measures offering hundreds of pounds of help to some households, but analysts believe bills could hit about £500 in January alone. The chair of the Commons Energy Committee, Darren Jones, agrees people need help now.
The autumn and winter is going to be very, very difficult for family finances, especially those on lower incomes. And that's why we think they should be bringing forward updates to their support package as quickly as possible, ideally in September, whether by an emergency budget or by other means.
The NHS is closing down its only gender identity clinic for children and young people. The Tavistock in North London had been criticised in an independent review about the treatment it offered some patients. Instead, the health service will open up a network of regional centres in Liverpool and London. Dr. David Bell, who was one of those who raised concerns about the service.
Their gender conflict and the dysphoria and the disturbance and the pain they were feeling was immediately accepted as being due to their being transgender, rather than having gender dysphoria. We now know there's a large group of detransitioners. These are the ones that I've met, are mainly young women, who are having to live with the terrible consequences of this inappropriate treatment.
Well, the clinic said its staff had worked tirelessly and under intense scrutiny in a difficult climate. The actor Bernard Cribbins has died at the age of 93. He was best known for featuring in Doctor Who, The Wombles, and the 1970 film The Railway Children. The comedian and actor Matt Lucas described him as a brilliantly talented man. And the weather, showers will continue across northern areas this evening, but elsewhere it should remain dry. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past six.
Jason, thank you very much.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song. When there's someone by your side to sing,
we are by your side till 7 o'clock, and then Joey's here with a shiny happy playlist. Plus a sofa session from rock royalty Jack White. Tonight's NPD.
Hi Sarah, it's John in Preston. Tonight we're having pork in pitters.
Pork in pitters. tomorrow on Breakfast Zoe's live from Birmingham City Centre, soaking up the excitement of the Birmingham 2022 Commonwealth Games.